Hello, I'm Ekta Chaudhary, scientist turned plant enthusiast. In today's video, I'm going to share with you pro tips from my new Skillshare class, where I talk about how to cultivate your own home garden. So are you ready? Let's get started. Now let's talk about the ultimate basic thing that you would need to grow a plant. Soil. Structurally speaking, there are three kinds of soil. Clay soil, silty soil and sandy soil. The first and foremost thing you should do is step out and inspect the soil that you have access to, let's say in your garden or just outdoors. Now let me show you how do I prepare the ideal soil for any kind of plant that I grow indoors or outdoors. I use equal amount of coco peat. This will help retain water for longer, allowing good drainage at the same time. Garden soil, which will act as a solid matrix for the roots to grow. If you don't have access to garden soil, it's okay. You can just use coco peat and compost. Compost will provide the necessary nutrition for the plants to grow. We use three of them in equal amount and mix them thoroughly. You can use this potting mix for growing any kind of plant, right from veggies to indoor plants. One thing plants are very sensitive to is watering. For how to water, you should be using a watering can. Now, this is a small watering can that you can use for 4 to 5 plants, but you have, let's say, more than 10 plants in your space. I recommend investing in a 5-liter watering can. Now, why do you need a watering can? One thing you would notice that is common between both of them is that the nozzle, it has a long neck. What this does is essentially reduce the water pressure. When you're watering your plants, especially the young ones that have delicate stems, if the water is from a great height and the pressure is too much, it can damage that stem. So I use this watering can for watering my indoor plants and this one for watering the outdoor plants. But if you do not have access to a watering can, an alternate that you can use is a PET bottle like this. Make a couple of holes on the cap and you're good to go. One of the most basic things that anybody needs to start a garden is of course a pot, which will help you contain the soil so that you can grow plants in them. This is a typical pot. This is a ceramic pot. You would see that the depth is about 5 to 6 inches. Whenever you go out to buy a pot, you would often see people saying this is a 6-inch pot or this is an 8-inch pot. It is essentially referring to the depth. And the diameter, which is the mouth of the pot, comes out to be in proportion with the depth of the pot. Now, of course, you can use a pot like this, but you can also get creative. For example, if you want to use a coffee mug, you can use it to grow plants. Just ensure that you make at least one drainage hole for the water to escape. If there's no drainage hole, the plant will start to die because the roots will start rotting. Now, there are other kinds of pots also available in the market, for example, a metal pot. Again, you would notice that it has a drainage hole. And the kind that I highly, highly recommend is a terracotta pot for two reasons. So terracotta pots help maintain the temperature for the soil better. And secondly, it also helps in a better growth of the plant. If you're a complete beginner and you don't want to invest much in the pots, you can actually grow your food even in containers like these that you use for takeaway food. The last thing that you need for your plants, and I hope it's not getting intimidating, I promise it's the last thing, is a fertilizer. What do you call a fertilizer? Anything that gives nutrition to your plants is a fertilizer. What I highly recommend is homemade compost. You can also buy compost from outside. But if you do not have a luxury of huge space, what I used to do in my hostel is get a seaweed solution. The way you use a seaweed solution is you take 5 to 10 ml of the seaweed solution and mix it with a liter of water. You can use this solution every once a month for all kinds of plants. It works for veggies, it works for indoor plants, outdoor plants, blooming plants, all kinds of them. The third kind of fertilizer that people actually use for the farmlands is urea. I don't really recommend it for home gardeners. Compost or seaweed solution is good enough for you. But if you want, you can also use urea. It works like steroids. If you add this to your plants, you would see a very good growth in them. But it is chemically made, and for home garden, you don't really need that. The fourth kind of fertilizer that you can have, especially if you're growing flowers, is fish bone meal. So this is steamed fish bone, which has been crushed and grinded into a powder form. If you do not have any ethical issues with it, you can use them in your plants. It works like magic for having more flowers on your blooming plants. All that you have to do is spot a node. Now, what is a node? Node is that junction from which you see another leaf coming out. So this is, let's say, the main stem. Here you see the leaf is coming out. You make a cut underneath. And this method works for most indoor plants or house plants. Now we put this in water. For any cutting to grow in water, all that you need is 2 to 3 healthy leaves. Now here I don't see a very good leaf, so I'll take another cutting. These 2 to 3 leaves will be enough for the plant to survive, and you put it in water. In about 7 to 10 days, from this junction, this node, you will see new roots coming out. Once you start seeing about 1 inch long root, you stick it into the soil. And in about 1 month, you will have a green and luscious pothos growing out of it. If you enjoyed watching this video, remember to check out the link below, which will take you to my complete Skillshare class, where I go deeper into the beautiful world of home gardening. And while you're here, remember to subscribe to Skillshare YouTube channel for more tutorials like this. I will see you in my class.